You can still go ahead and do something later. Here, unless you do, for example, customers, create customers, you can't really place orders, sales order, right? So whatever is to be done has to be done. That can't really work for them. So please ensure that you are able to do that. If you can't, tell us so that we will look at your screen and we'll see what problem you are having. Because otherwise you can't post it. Vaishali said, can we create company-specific masters? Vaishali, which master are you referring to? Yes, I mean, you are supposed to create this customer and item. Last time we shared this setup data, you have to create your this setup data in your ERP extensions.
Well, my query is, in my instance, I have already a new Electrons company. I have created new company, my own company. If I want to create a masters for my company, is it possible?
Yes, you should. I mean, are you going to use Inductrans as a company for this training, or are you going to use the new one?
New one. I have created my company.
Okay, then in that you should create these masters.
I have created the masters, but I want to create the masters specific to the company, not for Inductrans. I have set the default company as my company, but is it specific to my company or it is visible for new Inductrans company? That's my query.
So this is a, so ERPNX provides what we call a multi-company setup. So in single ERP instance, if you have multiple companies, they're supposed to be group companies and they do share customers and suppliers. The accounting books are going to be different for each of these companies, but the customers and partners are shared. You can at the most do a user level configuration where they will not be able to access, but I guess that also becomes not so useful. Typically, they're supposed to be shared. That's the whole idea about group companies.
Okay.
Saili, we'll be doing stock reconciliation and opening interest today. So we'll need to explain that. So I was only to told you to do up to item Excel sheet. The customers, suppliers and items. The only three things which I told you to do, sorry. Today we'll do opening entries and first stock reconciliation and then opening entries. Ashish.
Yeah. Can you see my screen?
Yes, I can see your screen.
So, this is how I created a new customer, sir. Let's say Tata Motors.
Okay.
And while I was saving it, actually, I had already given the name Tata Motors here. Okay. Mm-hmm. Means it is available there, right? But it is not showing here.
Okay. So do you see the three dots next to add customer? Just go to the customers again. Just see the three dots. Just click on that. Yeah. And see refresh. Is it refresh over there? It's not there.
No.
Okay.
Clear all the filters here.
Or how? I think filter here.
That one, all customer group and all territories.
Okay, this one. Why they get selected by itself? I did not select them. Yeah.
Then it might have got you right or realized it, but yes. So yeah, thanks.
Now I can see it. Yeah. Sorry.
Now you can see it, right? So now you'll need to check. Oh, cool. No problem. Okay, so you are kind of okay. You have all car models there. Nice.
Yes.
Nice.
Yeah.
Cool. So that's really nice to see that you are kind of creating your own companies and not giving this boring customer one, customer two, or unit part A, part B kind of. Very nice. Yes. Anyone else had any issues in entering master data?
Then I stop sharing, sir.
Sure. Did anybody else had issues with entering master data? Monica, will you please share your screen and explain to us what have you done? With how did you enter data? Can you just share your screen? Monica?
Yes, sir, just a minute.
Yeah, sure. I'm surprised to see that there are nobody found any errors in the data.
Hello, sir.
Yeah, please.
Sir, there is some issue in presenting screen my side.
Sorry.
Sir, issue aa raha hai screen share nahi ho rahi meri.
What issue are you getting? Can you tell?
You must grant permission in order to screen share. Cannot share your screen.
Any idea? Anybody can help? I don't think I have, because Ashish could share, that means, you know,
I think this problem is my side problem.
You please try reconnect once.
Yes.
Okay. Meanwhile, let us look at Ravi's screen. Ravi, can you share your screen and show what you did? Ravi, are you there?
नहीं सर, अगेन वही प्रॉब्लम आ रहा है, नहीं हो रही है.
Okay. Did you face any issue in entering data, master data?
No sir. मैंने मतलब हो गए सब entries कर लिए, customer, suppliers, items.
सब बराबर data डाल दिया क्या आपने?
हाँ, डाल दिया है.
Okay. Fair enough. Ravi, are you there? Ravi, are you there? Okay, he left meeting. Shubhangi, are you there? Shubhangi. Okay, I think if I call someone, then the person immediately leaves, right? Okay, Jitendra?
Hi, sir.
Yes, did you face any issue?
No, sir.
Okay. Actually, can you just share your screen and show us?
I'm not doing that activity, sir. Actually, I'm on leave. So, I already know the about the flow of the sales flow and customers. I'm experienced person. It's here.
No, that's fair. I just wanted to kind of share your screen and tell the class what did you do.
I'm nothing doing activities, sir, actually. I did not do anything on that, sir.
Actually, you didn't do it.
Yes.
Okay. Okay. Fair enough. Ruturaj, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Can you share your screen?
Yes, sir.
Can you share your screen and show what did you do? How did you enter data?
My screen is visible.
Yeah, it is
gone. Okay.
Yes.
I have started this setup from a company setup.
This is for everybody to kind of know what to just ensure that what he has done is correct, and if you miss something, you can always ask. Yeah.
Okay. This is my company, Patil Computers. Then I have set up the warehouses for my company using the warehouse tree. Here I have selected my company and created warehouses for it.
Okay, but we wanted only three warehouses, so you have to delete the remaining ones, right?
Okay, sir.
Yeah. So whatever you don't need, you should delete. You should not have a wrong data there.
Okay. Then I have entered the items. like this.
Okay. In item also. Okay. So you have. Okay. So you have made your own list of items, right?
Yes.
Just go down.
According to this sheet.
So here we have a part A, part B kind of thing. So we have similar things. Can you just show me that?
Okay. This is the material which have the atom code started with MR, okay, MR001. That are the parts. Okay.
Okay. Can you just show me all the records? We just how many records did you create? How many items? Then you just show list of records, all records. How many items do you have?
Currently, I have 15 records items.
Acha, 15 items
total. Yes. Okay. Some of from service, some of from
products,
assembly, sub assembly, and raw material.
Okay. Do you want to also show territories?
No, sir.
Show the territories.
No, I don't have added it.
Acha, you didn't create those territories.
Customer okay. And territories are remaining.
Okay. Okay. Fair enough. Good. Good. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. So we want one more person who has done all work so that we can look at it. So who would like to show, share your screen and show what you have done? Anyone volunteer to show whatever has been done? Complete work. Sumit, do you want to show, share your screen? Sumit, are you there? Sumit, are you there? Okay, fair enough. What we'll do, so you need to do all what we have not shown so far. Otherwise, we'll not be able to proceed further. Let me just show what I have done. So is there anybody who use import to get the data in, or did you only type in? Please raise your hand if you have used import. Okay, we shall say it now. Okay. Okay, do you see my screen?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
I'm just logging in. So I guess entering customer details, supply details, items list was not that complicated because you just need to go here. And this is what those who already started using it would know, but you can use the search bar. So you don't need to really know also where these actually are there. Then we used to teach that also, how to really go about finding where to find and all that. But now it is all there. We don't need to really worry about knowing where the particular menu is. I'll just show you what we had in the item. So for item list, I just have this kind of items which are there. There are 27 items that I have got here. So instead of entering these details manually, one by one, what I did is that there's something called the import here. So I just click on import. Now when you click on import, what happens is you can create a new data input. Now let me just show what I've done earlier. So I'll just open this. So you could specify document type, which is the item, and you have to say whether you want to insert new record or change the existing records. So you can say insert new records and you download a template. When you open a download a template, click on that, you will get a CSV file. It could be a CSV file, it could be Excel, but I would recommend using CSV file. Excel also has some version issues kind of things. You don't know which version you have, which version it accepts. CSV stands for comma separated values, which is basically a textual file. You can open in Notepad also. But by default, typically it opens in Excel. So it will not have any formatting or anything. It just has values. That's all. It just opens in Excel. That's all. So it comes very handy per se. And then here you have an option whether to say select fields to insert. You can either select all or you can select mandatory, which are necessary things. The ones in red are mandatory. What you should do more is that look at the Excel file that are shared and see that there are actually more things that we want to enter. Like for example, item name is not a mandatory field, but we want to enter that. So you could pick up that item name and those kind of things. And just click and then say export, it will create a CSV file which opens in Excel and you can enter the data over there, copy paste from whatever you have. This way you could not only insert new records, but you can also have existing records coming in the export and you can just make the changes in Excel and upload it. So this import facility is very useful when you're doing implementation because you have too much of data. For example, when you're doing implementation, one of our clients, we had some thousands of things, items and all that. You'll not have 5, 10, 20, 30 things. We just can't do it one by one. General data will be available in Excel. Either in Excel or it was in some other software which you can export to Excel. Only challenge that you have to do, the template that you get could be different, a different format. So you have to have your own template which comes from this data import file and they just put it in the right format first and you could be done. Okay. So those who are not done, I'm sure we'll have enough opportunities going forward to do data import. So wherever you see a chance to do the import, please do import. That definitely one thing that to learn from. Sometimes if you don't enter data correctly, then you may get errors. And it's kind of a trial and error sometimes. So it's not necessarily works. I think it's improved over the period of time. Over the versions, it has definitely improved the import facilities. But you could face issues. So if you have a small data, you can actually do it faster with just entering one after another. If you have a large data, then there's a challenge to do that. So try to doing it. I mean, whenever there are enough opportunities, you'll have to enter data later. So please give a try to import. Otherwise, I think it was very straightforward, simple thing that we had. I'm just giving kind of a last thing. Anybody had any issues with data entry? Please mention. Okay, I could see Vaishali said that use duplicate option for item creation. That's also a good way to do it. Quickly data entry. That's very nice. So anybody had any issues? Snehal, any challenge, any issue that you had? So it seems most of you have done it. Few of you have not done it, which is okay. Please do it as soon as possible. And it seems nobody has got an issue so far. So far, so good. Okay. Why it is important that you do it? Because if you don't do it and if you go ahead, somewhere we'll get stuck. And it will be difficult to figure out the problem later. So it's important that you do it. Okay. So let us now start with stock reconciliation. So please open the Excel that you have and just look at the stock reconciliation thing. And just tell me, what do you think? What is this data? Anyone of you, please comment. What is this data that you see in stock reconciliation worksheet? Or any idea what is stock reconciliation is? What are we doing? Have you heard this from before? Any guesses what is stock reconciliation could be? Okay, looks like it's a new term for all of you. So let me explain what is stock reconciliation. Can you see my Excel, or you are seeing the web page only?
Web page.
Yeah, Gupteshwar, you are seeing the web page only, right?
Yeah, web page.
Okay, thanks, Rishikesh. Okay, so I wanted to open Excel on your desktop and just have a look at it. So we're talking about a story of a person, and in my case, I said this to Sharvari, who has kind of started with his business. And when you start a business, you always, you not start using ERP software on day one. You just start, because that's the first thing that you do, right? To start a software, you start with the business, and then as business grows, you kind of, or as it is growing, you kind of start looking at how you can automate it. So before you automate, you need to have something to go, right? So typically any business that begins would have something already done. Like they would have bought assets, they would have actually sold something to customers, they would have got some suppliers in place, and so something would have been, transition would have been there. And we need to get, so when you start a software using ERP software, you need to have opening balance in accounting books. You need to have something to begin. Or now, for the sake of simplicity, what we have done is that we are assuming that this company that we are talking about has not done any business per se. It has got some customer suppliers identified, but has not immediately done any buying or selling transactions. But what it has got is some products and some raw material, some consumables in its stores. So that is the only thing it has got. So we will start with it. So whenever you have got this stock, and you need to put at valuation, because remember, in the balance sheet, we need to really see how much inventory that we have. When you say about which inventory, it's all about money. What is the cost of the inventory that we have? So that needs to be there in the accounting books, whatever the inventory that we have. So that we need to bring it in. Stock reconciliation per se is not only for opening balance. Stock reconciliation actually has a different meaning altogether. What happens is that you have this digital record of how much stock we have. So obviously you will have hundreds of, or thousands of items. And there is so much of records that are maintaining, how many balance, what is the quantity that you have. Incidentally, in physical world, you may not have the exact prescription. So here you may be saying that I have a consumable one is 30, but in actual reality there will be only 50. There will be only 50. Or you may be seeing here something like as 300. Actually, you would have something like 220, or it could be other way around also. They could have 500 also. So physical world and the digital world could be different. So numbers could be different. So the way people do it is that at least once in a year, if not more time, you know, could do once in a month also. But at least once in a year, the company will take undertake exercise called stock reconciliation. Reconciliation means you know, kind of you look at what is the digital thing, what is the physical thing, and have a sync up these both these things. Okay. So obviously, which will rule? The physical world. So in physical world, you have only 20 items, and your digital world shows 30. You have to change it digital, right? You can't change physical, because physically you have 20. Many times it happens that something gets damaged and all that. So you need to clearly take a stock of it. And at the end of the year, you kind of say, okay, this is what the stock, physically correct stock that we have. And then accordingly make the corrections in the ERP process. So you need to kind of make changes in the digital world. So you need to make the quantities change accordingly. Very rarely, but you may also change valuation rate, so the value of that particular quantity. You may change, may not change, but a quantity may need to be changed. So that is something that we need to be aware of, that this happens once in a year. Sometimes some companies may do it once in a month kind of thing, once in a quarter kind of thing. Whenever it's not, the frequency is not mandated by ERP. You could choose any frequency that you want to do, but ensure that, you know, you do it so that there is no inconsistency between what is there in ERP and what is there in the physical area. So that you need to kind of sync up. So here we see that data. So we say that we already have 10 portable drives. We have already got 5 laptops, 10 desktops, and we have got some 30 consumable one and consumable two. That data, that thing is with us in a way. So that we need to kind of reconcile person. Okay. And then when we are putting this, you know, so we are following a double entry accounting. So is there anybody who's accounting background? Let me see if there is anybody who has accounting background. Oh, here we get a CA. Jen, are you there? Okay, Dhananjay is here. Very nice. So Dhananjay, would you like to talk about the double entry accounting system, what it is for the benefit of audience, because the majority of engineers. Dhananjay? Would you like to unmute and just tell us about double entry accounting system, what it is? Dhananjay, can you hear me? Can you, are you there? Okay, Dhananjay is not there. So, okay, so, so double entry accounting system is that we do something like credit and debit. Now I'm not going to teach you all that credit debit. So it's a topic in itself. But we need to know that, you know, when we are doing these entries in stock reconciliation, we need to adjust the differences somewhere. You know, you can't be just one way. Now when we are doing stock reconciliation at yearly basis, you may put those whatever the differences in some differences kind of account, recovery specific account, where you kind of write off that amount. So for example, if you think that you have maybe 1.5 crores worth of inventory, but what you found actually is 1.4 crores of inventory, the 10 lakh has to be kind of returned. So that you do against another account. For the time being, since we are doing opening balance, we'll use a difference account called temporary opening. It's a very special account that is used only for doing opening balance. Okay. So when we are doing opening balance, we'll be passing many opening entries, as you see in the next worksheet. We'll be passing some opening entries. All these entries will be also called as is opening as yes. And these openings will be, suppose we are passing an opening balance equity, for example, opening balance equity or opening balance in the bank or something. Against that, we will have this another account called temporary opening. In a way, whenever we do all these things, ultimately, we should be able to have this temporary opening as zero. That kind of closes our opening balance. So the way you do opening balance is that you have many balances to many accounts to open. Like, for example, you have balance equity, then you have banks, you may have some account receivable, accounts payable, whatever accounts that you need to have open. Now you are doing one after another. So what you typically do is that you use a temporary opening account against it, and then at the end of the opening thing, your temporary account opening balance should be zero. Once that is become zero, means your opening balance is currently done. Now, if this is looking great to you, let me go ahead and show you the chart of accounts and see what we are talking here. So let me just go here and search on chart of accounts. And here you see a chart of accounts. Now, do you see here something familiar? Application of funds, shares of funds. Do you see something similar, familiar? Okay, so I think earlier session we kind of concluded with a confusion that whether the assets are application of funds or source of fund, or we actually asked the question that what is the source of fund? Is it assets or liabilities? And many of you said actually assets. But I think you have looked at it, you have appeared for quiz now and all that. So before I get into chart of accounts, let me just clarify about it. So is this making sense to you, that application of funds is assets and source of funds is liabilities? Is this making sense to you now after going through this slides again and after appearing for quiz, after studying it? Are you now convinced that application of funds is assets and source of funds is liabilities, or you are not sure? Please raise your hand if you are still confused, which is a good sign. That means you're thinking. So please raise your hand if you want some clarification on application of funds and source of funds. Dhananjay has raised hand. Very nice. Dhananjay, can you unmute yourself and speak up?
Hello.
Yes, yes, Dhananjay.
Yes, sir. I'm clear about that.
Oh, you're clear about it. Okay.
Yeah.
Good. So, what about Ashish? Are you clear about it, or do you have a doubt about application of fund and source of fund?
Actually, I'm a bit biased between whether I'm clear about it or still confused. But I would like to say, sir, please correct me if I'm wrong. As far as the time is concerned, I think whenever you spend some funds to grab some assets, and after some period of time, those assets becomes a source of fund for you. Is this right? The way I'm talking, sir. Did you get my point?
Yeah, let me refine it a little bit, but let us wait for others to respond.
Yeah.
So good that you said it. And I think it's important that you kind of share what you are understanding, so that it also helps me to understand what are you getting confused about. So thanks for that. Let me wait for others. And by the way, it is good that you say you are confused, because that means you are thinking about it. So there are only two ways you will not be confused. One is once you understood it fully. And second is that when you are not understanding anything, then you are not confused, right?
Yeah.
So in between you will be confused. So it's good to See, that is a confusion. But what about others? Others have understood fully, or you are not sure? So I heard Ashish. What about others? Yes, Rishikesh. Can you unmute and speak up? Yes, Rishikesh. Rishikesh, can you unmute and speak up? Okay, I'm not sure what's the challenge. Fair enough. Anybody else about this application of funds, source of funds? Rishikesh, you're not audible here. You're not able to hear you. Rishikesh, we are not able to hear you. We see you are unmuted, but you are not audible, at least to me. What about others? Others are able to hear you?
Yes, sir.
Kanaya, can you hear Rishikesh?
No, no. Rishikesh, you can disconnect and connect again if you are facing issue.
Okay. Last call. Any other than Ashish Kumar, anybody else has any confusion, or are you clear about it?
Guys, please speak out. See, first of all, the objective of this training is that this is going to be required once we get into the implementation of live projects. So if you are going to fail in the live project, then it is going to be a issue for you. We expect that you get the required utilization of these training sessions and try to speak out and ask all kinds of queries, whether it is a small query or big query. It doesn't matter. But don't hesitate to
speak. Am I audible?
Yes, Nupur. Yes,
Nupur. Yes, sir. I have a question. Can we say application of funds can be defined as we can invest our funds there? I mean, application of funds is investment of a company of the funds. Is this the right statement, sir?
Yes, it's actually putting funds to use. So application of funds is actually use of funds in a way. So you are using funds for something, which is what you are building. Jen, are you not able to hear me? Yeah. Thanks, Nuhur.
Yeah, thank you, sir.
Okay. So look at this way. Let me explain it now. Look at this way. Company is a separate entity. Now we have been, if you recall, we talked about entity concept, and so company is a separate entity. It is separate from the owner. Okay. The company, let us say New Intech Trans is a company, it's a separate entity. It has got some use of funds, right? So assets it has got, maybe it has got building, it has got some machineries and all that. These are all use of fund or application of fund. This is how the funds are utilized per se. And from where these funds have come? So these funds could come from owner of the company who has put an equity there. the funds would have come from customers who are kind of paying, right? So there is customer account receivables and those kind of things, or the loans that have been taken from the bank. So liabilities are basically nothing but from the where the funds are coming from. So funds are coming from owners, they're coming from banks, they're coming from customers. Customers are giving you credit particularly. So that is also a kind of a fund for the company. So that is what we call a liability. The company owes that. And use of funds or the application of funds is it is used to buy assets. It could be a plant, it could be a machinery, it could be even bank accounts. It has some own investment. All is using that fund. So the application of funds is nothing but use of funds. And hence, what are the applications of fund is the same question as what are the assets of the company. So when you say this company has got assets, these are basically how the company has used its funds. So that's the basic one, is use of funds or application of funds as assets. And the liabilities are nothing but the way you kind of got the funds. Either you got it from the owners or banks or credit from the customer. And all that, these are all source of fund or liabilities. Now, assets and liabilities are the traditional way we use this heading, like these are the assets, these are the liabilities. But many times I have seen it, particularly when teaching finance to non-finance executives or the students, is that we carry a notion in our mind that assets are good and liabilities are bad. I mean, we should not have liabilities, we should have only assets. But when it comes to company, assets equal to liabilities, and this kind of people find it difficult to understand what it is. Confusion arises largely because we have in our mind somewhere that assets, we should have all assets but no liabilities. But that is not the way you should look at company, and hence application of funds and sources of funds are a better way or a better terminology, because then there is no bias that we have in our mind about, you know, these terms called assets and liabilities. So I preferably use these terms, application of funds and sources of funds, because that is very clear. Application of funds is how funds are used, and sources of funds is from where the funds are coming. And that, I guess, is simplified. But you should know, particularly if you're doing ERP Next implementation or ERP Next customization, you should be aware of both the terminology. Whether you should say assets or whether you should say application of funds. They essentially mean the same thing. Does it clarify? Ashish, Nupur, does it clarify?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Good. So, so let us look at the chart of accounts, which is an important piece to begin the implementation. So whenever we implement ERP, the first thing we do is look at chart of accounts. Now, when you set up a company, you get a new fresh instance and start with a company, it will ask which country it is. And depending on the country, it will actually load the default chart of accounts. So country-wise, there are different chart of accounts. But within a country, you would have their own chart of accounts. Rather, each company will have its own chart of accounts, which is very, very different from other countries. And there is a reason for it, because chart of account is what is created by the accountant, and they would create the account as and when required. So you will have a very different account. And generally, when you create an account, suppose you create an account in 2001, you know, and you had some entries against that account, and after 2003, you are no longer using that account, still you will not delete that account. You will carry over that account. So anytime you create an account, it is kind of there all the time. So you're not supposed to delete that kind of account. So in accounting, that is a kind of a thing. Even in ERP, we'll go ahead and see that whenever we make any entry, any transactions, you're not supposed to delete the transaction. You can make a reversal entries, but you're not supposed to delete anything once it is printed. So you will have these kind of accounts which are there. So many times what happens, all the times, we first get the chart of account, which is India specific, and then we see what the company's chart of accounts, existing chart of accounts, and then we kind of start making entries in this chart of accounts. Now this chart of account may have maybe 20, 30 accounts per se. So this is a tree, as you can see here. This is a tree, and then there are leaf level accounts where you actually make entries. But actually speaking, you would have literally thousands of accounts in many cases to kind of do. So you should know where to create that entity. So here, whatever accounts we are seeing are created by default. And for training sessions, we'll use them. We'll not make any changes. So we'll actually stick to whatever is there. We may add one or two accounts later if we get into it. But then we'll kind of stick to it. But you should be able to figure out which account belongs to what, which requires some accounting knowledge. Without accounting knowledge, you can't do that. Now, my intention is not really to train you on accounting, so I will not get into that details. But if you're dealing with accounts model anytime in future, either to do customization or to do implementation, basic knowledge of accounting is mandatory. Okay, you should know what is credit, debit, and those kind of things. Okay. So we just look at it to see whether it, whatever we learned so far is kind of making sense. So let us start with the simplest one, which is expenses. In expenses, there are two categories basically: direct expenses and indirect expenses. Direct expenses are nothing but what we call as the stock expenses. That you have bought stock. Why it is called direct? Because if you are manufacturing something. Let us say you are manufacturing a chair and some desk, you are manufacturing the benches. All that will use some kind of wood, right? Or if you use some metal out there. Now you know that this chair required this much of wood, right? So it's a direct kind of expense. And if you have created maybe hundreds of chairs, you know how much kind of wood it is needed kind of wood. So that is what called as a direct expense, or what is in accounting terms, we record the cost of goods sold, kind of thing. But now, when you're actually doing this production work, you know, say in a plant or on a shop floor kind of thing, use electricity, right? You use a lot of consumables. You have people working on, who are working on multiple things. You know, you have managers who are, need to make telephone calls and you know, order some food or order some raw material and all that, so you have to take one those costs and all. All that will go in indirect expenses, which you here we see administrative expenses, entertainment expenses, marketing expenses, legal expenses, office rent, postal expenses, sales expenses, salary, telephone expenses, travel expenses and all that. So you will see all these expenses out here. This is a big list of expenses. You don't need all of it in most cases. Some cases there could be even longer list, depending on the company to company, they would have very long list of such expenses. Now, if you really don't need that account, you should delete that account. You should not have any account or in a chart of account which is not to be used, okay? Because it unnecessarily creates kind of overhead. You don't need to delete it, so you just get rid of it, don't need it. But if it is there, you have to include that. So many times you could have very funny expenses. You know, entertainment expenses are actually not very funny. It is used essentially means that whenever you have parties, for example, big parties, all that expenses are booked in this entertainment expense. So these are kind of indirect expenses. Obviously, there are many more accounts. We will learn them as we go along. So don't worry about it. We are just looking at what is a mota moti mein samajh ke lete hain ki kya kya expenses. So direct expenses, indirect expenses. Direct means there are typically stock expenses that we are looking. Then income, there is again direct income and indirect income. Direct income is could be divided into sales and service. So if you are providing product sales and you also do services, then you have sales and service. For example, Electrans only does services, so we may only have services as a thing. You may not have sales as another thing. Or you may call that as a sales. It's all up to us how do we want to really name these accounts first. Indirect income is that, for example, Electrans had some old computers which they sold off at some point of time. That's the income that was generated, which is not a direct income. That is not a business which Electrans is, right? But it has some got income, which is non-related to business. So that could come in the indirect income. That's why we have this. In our case, we are in the startup account, there is nothing, no account below. This is just a categorization. We don't need it for our training program, but in some cases, we may want to put account. So whatever you see as a folder icon or what is a group node, this is the terminology used across ERPnext. This is called group node, and you don't enter data here. You enter data against in the actual leaf node, which is what you see with the simple circle over there. So this is the income. Then comes to liabilities. So again, you click here. You will see there are two. Owner's equity is called capital account in this partner. So these are alternative terms, and you should know all of these terms. So otherwise, you get confused. Are you getting my voice clear, or is there any disturbance? Is my voice clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, voice is clear.
So here you have capital account, which is what nothing but owner's equity. There are two things. One is the shareholders' funds, which is the original equity that is bought in, original fund that is bought in, or subsequently if there is IPO, initial public offering, or there is sale of shares, that will come up here. And reserves or surplus are the ones where all your net profits get accumulated. If the company is running for 20 years, all its profit or losses, whatever that is, it's kind of get accumulated and get in the reserves and surplus. So that is what capital account is. It's basically owner's equity. And then the current liabilities. So here we have accounts payable. This is what the vendors that you need to pay. So vendors are giving you credit. Like whenever you buy something from a vendor, let's say you buy a lot of wood from a vendor, you don't pay upfront. Rather, in the industry, nobody pays upfront. People provide some kind of credit. So when I buy something from a vendor, the vendor will say, pay me within 30 days, or pay me within 3 months, or something like that, 90 days. So there are terms which are there. So you generally give some credit. Nobody pays immediately. So you get a credit. So that is a source of fund for you, right? I mean, when I start a business, I don't need to upfront pay anybody. I mean, I just take it on a credit. So that is source of fund. But it's also liability. Either way you see it, either you see it as a source of fund or you see it as a liability. Either way, it actually means the same thing. So you have creditors, which are basically vendors. There's a term which is used, creditors, which are vendors. They've given a credit to you. And second is payroll payable. So as I said, as an employee also, we are giving credit to the company, right? So when somebody joins a company, suppose that person worked for 15 days, the company actually owes him or her the 15 days salary. Okay? But no company will pay the salary on a daily basis or a weekly basis. They will pay the bill on a monthly basis. So that is again a credit that the employer is giving to the company. So it is again a source of money. We don't think it so much when we are doing the day-to-day business, right? But accountants have to kind of start thinking all of that. Then duties and taxes. So the taxes to be paid to government. So again, you may be collecting taxes when you make a sale. Like whenever you're selling something, you put on GST, 18%, 12%, whatever GST is. So all that tax you get, which you need to pay to government. Now you don't pay to government immediately. So this is a payable to government. So that is again, you kind of have it against that account. So you'll get the amounts in this account per se. Then you have a loans, which are, again, here it is three types it is given. Bank overdraft account. So sometimes you can have an overdraft to the bank account, that if you want some money, suppose you have 30 lakh rupees in account, you need to issue a check for 35 lakh rupees. You can issue that. Bank will honor the check, but it will put that 5 lakh rupees as kind of a loan. It's some higher interest rate. But the advantage of having that overdraft account is that you don't need to really worry about, you know, whether you have balance or not. Many times companies work a very tight cash flow situation. Particularly if you're running a small business, you're really in a tight cash flow situation. It's really a challenge to manage cash flow. If you're an employee, you may not realize it, but when you run a company, I run my own company, I know how it is become tight to handle the cash flow part of it. So overdraft comes handy because you may need to pay out maybe salary or to the vendor, and you may not have a balance in account, you could get an overdraft from the bank. So that's a bank overdraft account. You could have a secured loan. Secured loans are the loans against which you have some collateral. For example, if you say this machine is a collateral, in case I default on the loan, the bank will come and take over that machine and sell it off in the market to recover its loan. So that's called secured loans. Loans which are secured means some kind of collateral which is given. Then there are unsecured loans. There is no specific collateral given. It's all in the company's reputation. So big companies, large companies like L&T and all that, or Tata's, can hire, you know, actually borrow money without giving any collateral. Because, you know, there is a reputation. Bank will believe that, you know, this company will pay back. As against a small company, it will not have a great reputation. So they may not get as much unsecured loan. Or they get an unsecured loan at a very higher interest rate. So there are different ways, you know, you can get loan. So that comes in unsecured loans. This is again a liability, loans liability. And then you have stock liabilities, that you have received stock but not yet billed. Sometimes it happens, you receive stock but it is not yet billed. So that you can park it over here. These are the liabilities part of it. And finally, assets, which we again seen. So there are current assets and there are fixed assets, there are investments. So current assets are account receivable, which is what you are you're supposed to get from the customer. Okay, so you kind of cover debtors. So that is same as account receivable. So you could have debtors. Then whatever money that you have in bank account. Now this BOM. So Gupta, this Bank of Maharashtra you mentioned. Is Bank of, I think it's.
Yes, it's Bank of Maharashtra.
Bank of Maharashtra.
Okay. So while set up, it needs to. Yeah.
Okay. So when setting up the account, you would have mentioned that bank is the Bank of Maharashtra. So we just say BOM, that's the Bank of Maharashtra. So this is what you have. So you would have many bank accounts. So this is only one, but typical company would have many bank accounts. Sometimes companies also have fixed deposits. So they open up older or fixed deposits. Then you have cash in hand. So that is mentioned here, cash in hand. Again, you may have some cash in this branch, some cash in another branch. You may have multiple accounts for that. Then you have loans and advances that you have given. Please note, there are two times you see loans and advances. One is the loans and advances, which is liability, which is what you borrowed. But these are the loans and advances that you have given. So as I mentioned, I think earlier, employees typically ask, nowadays companies don't get into that thing. But earlier companies used to actually give loans to employees. So, or advances. Somebody will come and say, can you give me advance? And then adjust against the salaries kind of thing. So that all will be coming here. Then securities and deposits. So many times when you bid for a big contract and all that, you need to put some deposit with that. Plan, with that potential client that you are bidding. So if you bid, you win the contract, but you don't execute the order, then they will take away that earnest money from you. Otherwise, they will refund it. So it's kind of a use of fund or asset that you have got. So that is what is here. The stock assets, that is again that you have got stock in hand, and tax assets. So if you have got some tax kind of with you, then you could have this out here. In fixed assets, you have buildings, capital equipment, which are like big equipment, electronic equipment, furniture and fixtures, office equipment. Again, this list could be different for different companies. This is just a sample list, which is there. And you also have accumulated depreciation, which we talked about earlier. Then there are investments, which you may have. And finally, there is something called a temporary account, which is not really a part of chart of accounts, so to say. But this is specifically used when you are doing opening balances. So in accounting, whenever you make an accounting transaction, you make an entry against two accounts. That is where you might have heard about credit, debit kind of thing. So you make entries against two accounts, credit and debit. So you credit something, the same account you debit. Now, it could be actually more than one account, but credit amount must be equal to debit amount. Debit amount, that is how you do the kind of credit debit thing. Okay, we will not get into that much details, but whenever you're making an entry against a capital account where you're going to opening balance, you don't have a corresponding opposite entry there. So that you do in a temporary account. So you will do all these opening balances entries and whatever the opposite entry, you will put in temporary account. And when all is done, your temporary account becomes zero. And that's the ultimate use of this temporary account. You, again, you may not want to delete it, but temporary openings is what you can make to zero. You may create some additional suspense account or some kind of a thing people used to create. So whenever you can't really tally things, right? I mean, there is so much mismatch, some you see there. You use that kind of a temporary account just to do this adjustment sort of thing. Not a good idea. When people used to do it in paper, there used to be a big challenge to tally accounts per se. But when you use ERP, I guess things become pretty straightforward. You don't need to really do that. But yes, if it is complex, then you may need to have that kind of adjustment. So again, you need to have an accountant to really do chart of accounts. I mean, whenever do ERP implementation, we work with accountants specifically. Chart of accounts is something that we actually consult accountant of the company to get. We just go ahead and create accounts, but we really don't decide that this company needs this expenses account. Let the company or the company's accountant tell us what we should have. Okay, so this is a chart of accounts. Any questions, doubts?
Hi, Vaishali here.
Yes, Vaishali.
Is this a standard setup of chart of account?
This is what you get out of box when you install.
Suppose for my company, I want to create a chart of account same like this. Can I copy this or is there any other option?
So you can actually modify this. So every company will have only one chart of account. So this is just comes in out of box for India specific. And then you go ahead and delete or edit or whatever, add child, you could do that.
Actually, my next question was that is this country specific? Suppose for a US client, I want to create a chart of account. Is there any standard setup available?
Yes. So when we implement ERP Next, install ERP Next, it will ask the company's home country. And whatever country we specify, here it has to be India that is specified. It has got a standard chart of account, which it just puts in there. Now, this is just a starting point for us. It could, we actually need to change it. I mean, nowhere you will use it as it is, unless the company is brand new. But most of the cases, 100% cases, you actually make changes. And you actually delete the ones which you don't need. That is also important. So, for example, there are so many expense accounts which may not be relevant for the company. You simply go ahead and delete it. You don't keep it for the sake of it. So your chart of accounts should actually be same as what chart of accounts used by the company. If it's a brand new company, still you need to consult the accountant of the company to see what accounts should be there and what should not be there. And get rid of all the unnecessary accounts.
Okay. Also, I can do grouping. Suppose in salary account, I need additional salary or daily wages, that kind of grouping. If I
yes,
need,
yes,
that can be
yes.
Also possible in this.
Yes, yes. You could always create new child notes and those kind of things. Let us do it. I mean, maybe let us in expenses only we do it. So we'll just create add child. And then you can put, let us delete it. So we'll just put test group. So we can say is group. So that becomes now you may put account number. Typically, those who have chart of accounts, existing chart of accounts, will have their own account numbers. They need to put in, otherwise, this will be just add. ERP doesn't require it, but many people require it. They need to say root type. So that you need to mention whether it's asset, liability, equity, income, or expense out of this. If you're saying expense, that root has to be mentioned. And then account type. Again, there are different types of accounts. This is where you need C CAs or accountants help. Let us say we say expense account. So what is the expense account? It's pretty simple. But for example, you are opening a new bank account. There is a bank over here. Or as I said, cash. So there are three branches. So you have cash in branch one, cash in branch two. All are cash accounts. So you could put it that way. So here we are having income, expense. So just put expense account. Currency, generally, we already mentioned INR as a currency. So we don't need to worry about it. Company, this is by default, I have only one company. But if you have two companies, you need to select the right company. Or the default company will come in here. And then you just create me. So let us see, it has come here. Yes, test group is here. Now you can't make entry against it because you need to have add child. So let's say add child. Now I'll put a test. It's not a group, but account type is again, I'll say expense. And it doesn't require to have a root because it's already part of the test group, so it cannot text from there. And just click create. And you have got this kind of a set. Now I could delete this. And we say permanent delete. Say yes. And it says cannot delete test group because it has child nodes. I need to go ahead, go first, delete the child node, delete, hopefully it is deleted, yes, and then I can go and delete this. By the way, once you have amounts there, once you have some entries made there, then it will be very difficult to delete that. So you have to be careful about that part. By the way, in ERP Next, when we do some of these transactions, this is pretty dynamic. So it kind of happens, but sometimes you may need to do the refresh. Somewhere here, refresh. Either refresh here. So if you see that you deleted something but it's still there, or you added something which is not seen here, you just do refresh once, and that will take care. So anywhere you can go, add child, add new account per se. Only thing is that whenever account adding something, you mention the right type, right chart type, and those kind of things. Otherwise, it could have serious issues. So again, how do you know which is the right type, account type? You have to consult the accountant. We may not be expert in accounting, but we should be able to talk to consultant and the accountant and tell him that this is what we want to do. And this chart of account has to be finalized, approved by the accountant of the company before we go ahead and do anything, any transactions. For this company. Any questions? Any further questions? Okay. Yes, Jayant actually has responded earlier that yes, country specific chart of account COA is based on laws applicable and nature of business activity. So, services companies or software services companies COA, chart of accounts, will be drastically different or very much different than for manufacturing companies chart of accounts. So you will see those differences. While we are here, let me quickly show you financial statements. And obviously there's nothing much to show here, but right now we see balance sheet and there is nothing, I think. Do not show anything, right? Nothing to show. Similarly, there are all other statements. There's nothing to see here. The reason I wanted to, rather, I want to see these also before we go. But as we do transactions, you will see this getting updated automatically. Okay, the balance sheets and profit and loss statement, cash flow statement. So that is another advantage of ERP. That earlier, without any software, this is all needs to be prepared. Financial statements need to be prepared for the same. But when you are using ERP, this gets automatically updated. It's a report at the end of the day. So you could always see that the report out there. So it's a good idea to kind of see how this financial statement change as you make the business transactions. Okay, so let us go ahead and do the stock reconciliation. So let me just IPIN. Any questions, please ask. Stock reconciliation disk. Okay, and now let us do a create first stock reconciliation. Okay, so here I'll go ahead and I just do this whatever drives I have 10. So I have to say series, I'll just not make any changes here, I'll just take it as it is. This is just a posting date and all that. This is ultimately what we say accounting instrument. So it is, has its posting date and time. Both are kind of there. They are default, but you may do a backdated entry service. And you also see opening stock. This is important. You need to mention opening stock. And then you have to have an item code. So I have a portable drive. So let me just hit drive. Yeah, portable drive. It's here. Warehouse, it's, I think we have finished goods. That's correct. Finished goods. We have 10 in quantity. You can change this quantity, it's up to you. But just ensure that you know what you are entered. Then valuation rate, I will say 5,600. And that is one thing that I added. Second, I have five laptops. So let me just put that here, laptop. Five laptop. Again, finished goods. Let's say five laptops. And the valuation rate is 20,000. Yes. Okay. So the inflation has gone up. Anyway, we put that. Then we have 10 desktops. I mentioned we have desktop. And desktops and the valuation. Oh, why it is coming like this? 10.00. A valuation is 19,000. So we are done. Difference account is a temporary opening. That has come because I guess we said opening stock. So this is come. We're not getting into the cost center now. That this is simplistically we have put it. So that is all we need to do. Let's just say save. Okay. So then you submit this document to confirm. So all these entries that we are making, all the screens that you see, is all called document in ERP and experiments. And it's also called a doc type. So this is a doc type of stock reconciliation. So if you say customer, it's a doc type. And then you create documents, it's actually creating new records. They're called documents. So sometimes we use the word record. This is very traditional one. But in ERP next parlance or ERP next terminology, it's all called document. So all these documents typically are created in draft and then they're submitted to confirm. So why this double work? The double work is there because one is, are you sure? Lock or do kind of a question. That is the one way to see it. But most of the time, there could be two different persons in a company. One who would create these documents or records. The other one who will approve, this check and approve these documents. So many of cases, you will have a workflow where a clerical person or a kind of a, we'll say, let us say clerk, will create these documents. And then the supervisor or the immediate supervisor will confirm, will submit this document and hence confirm. Once confirmed, you're not supposed to delete it. Now let me tell you, in ERP next, I guess there is a way to delete things, which is no. I mean, when you do implementation, maybe you do that. But otherwise, you actually don't delete anything. ERP, for example, SAP ERP, you simply can't delete anything. You're not supposed to delete anything. Everything should get locked. So generally, when we are doing implementation, we do delete things because we make mistakes, frankly speaking. But ideally speaking, we should not delete it. And operations, once you start using ERP next, you should not allow people, you should tell people not to delete anything, or you should not give them rights if required to delete anything. So once you submit, it is done. Before submitting, you can go ahead and delete it. So that delete is here. And there's a shortcut also, keyboard shortcut, if you want. but let us assume we are okay to go ahead. We'll just say submit, and we'll ask again, confirm, and we'll say yes, submit, and we are done. So there is a small bell that rings. So I don't know if you heard that, but there's a ring. It says you are done. Okay. So now let us go ahead and also actually two more we have to do. So we could have done it here itself, but we go ahead and create another stock reconciliation. And I mean, we could have done that here also, but the posting time, it is coming in, purpose, opening stock, I have consumables. I take consumable 01. This is in raw material, warehouse, 30 and 200. And then we add another row and say 02. Here. And here you use 15 and 15. So we do save, put and temporary open, that's fine, save and submit. Okay. Now we could also throw opening balance, but since we are here, let us go to accounting. Look at chart of accounts and refresh. You see, in temporary accounts, there is this amount, which is 372,750. That's in temporary account. And should be somewhere matched here. We have a stock, right? Okay, you see in stock assets, this thing over here, stock in hand, 3,72,750. Okay. So you could always go ahead and check this. This is what the balance sheet will not be. Okay. Right now there's nothing much there. But you could more of a curiosity check up these things. Let us go to opening balance. Here we are making journal entries. So let us do journal entries. Now what we are doing here is that we want to have an opening balance equity. That is what we want to do. So somewhere here, down here, here more information. Each opening has to be yes. This setting, you should not make a mistake. No? This is what is mentioned here in the Excel sheet, but please ensure that each opening is yes when you are doing these two general entries. So we are doing a journal entry. We'll do opening balance equity on account here. Equity. It's not there. What is called equity in this our chart of accounts? Anybody? What do we call owner? Stop. Share rule funds. Now, whether it should be credit or debit, I'll send you this kind of a couple of articles to read what, how should you decide what is a credit and what is a debit. There are three golden rules of accounting, how to do it. I will share that with you, but we'll not get into so much of detail because we need to only make a couple of entries. But if you're interested, please read that for that. So I just said 10 lakh is credit. This is the funds that Sharvari has in, put invested, so 10 lakh. And against that, I have to make a temporary opening. And this is 10 lakh, so this is done. Total debit 10 lakh, total credit 10 lakh, we are kind of done. Here, credit, debit, and I just save it. Okay, and I submit. Again, these are not supposed to be deleted later, so very important that you do it carefully.
Backdated entries are possible because my if my cutoff date is 31st March, so how to put opening balance on 31st March?
No, so you can do opening balance, but whatever date you decide, but you can do backdated entries. But once you close the account for a year, then you can't make entries in that year. For example, we have current financial year is 21-22, so we can do backdated entries. Till we do the, so there is some period closing or year closing. Typically, we do year closing. Some companies do monthly closure or quarterly closure. Yearly closure is mandatory. Once you close that year, then you can't go and do entries there in that year first.
But in general,
you can do backdated entries for say yesterday, last week. Those things you could.
For opening balances, I couldn't see the option for. Changing posting date.
No, so for example, we are doing this ad journal entry. There is a posting date here, which is today's date.
Yes, is it editable?
It is editable. You can change it.
Okay.
You can change it. You should not change it to the previous financial year, typically. If it is now, in our case, we just started, so it doesn't really matter. But typically, you close the account for a year, then you can't anyway go ahead and do backdated entry in last financial year. And in general practice, not to do too much of backdated entry. But you could. I mean, doctor will not stop you from doing it.
You could, because in stock reconciliation, there is a specific checkbox, if you see, edit posting date. Here, couldn't see that.
Yeah, here it is changeable. Here you could edit this. This could be 18 months.
Okay. In stock reconciliation, you have to specifically select that checkbox.
Because there, you're doing it for that particular few. It's kind of, ideally, you should not do backdated. For stock reconciliation, the challenge is, once you do it on that date, that gets kind of formed up. So, stock reconciliation is something where you're kind of putting absolute values. You can't really, you're supposedly checking the physical balance and putting it there. So you have to be very careful about the posting date in stock reconciliation. When you're doing general entries, it's very common that you make backdated entries or you do entries for a particular date. So here it is pretty much editable.
Okay, thanks.
So let us go ahead and now the bank entry. Now what? Let us think this way. We have started a business. We started a business by putting up equity of 10 lakh rupees, right? So that's a balance that we have. Out of that, we have spent some money in buying those laptops and consumables, right? Whatever stock that we have. Whatever is remaining should be in a bank. Okay? So that amount I want you to verify, do the calculation, and then put in a bank. So let me just show my entire screen so that I can show you the Excel file. Let me know whether you can see my Excel file.
Can you see my Excel file?
Yes, sir.
Yes, can you see Excel file now?
Yes, sir, yes.
Yes, sir.
So here we put 10 lakh with opening balance equity and temporary opening I put 10 lakh. Credit debit I have mentioned here, so you don't need to worry too much about it. Now, please note that so all that money would have been in a bank, actually speaking, 10 lakh once you put in. But you already got some stuff over here, the finished goods and the some raw material. You got it, right? So that money spent, the remaining money should come in the bank. Okay, so that amount you have to calculate and put in the right entry accordingly. Whatever amount you debit for the bank, in our case, Bank of Maharashtra, BOL. You have to credit with the temporary opening. After you pass this entry, you should go and check whether the temporary opening account has become zero or not. Okay. If it is not zero, then you are done the wrong calculation. This is very simple calculation. So I don't think you make a mistake here. But you should be able to figure out that your temporary opening becomes zero afterwards, after making this entry. Okay. Make a proper entry. Then go ahead and go in chart account, check whether temporary opening account has become zero or not. And go and check your balance sheet, your profit and loss statement, cash flow statement. Okay. When you come back for the next session, I will actually want everyone who have finished all of that. Because they will start with the sales transaction. Now we have done the setup, not fully. I mean, you need to do it. Unless you do it, you can't say it. But it is required to be done. So if you have any issues, don't wait till next session. Please put it in the group that you are facing some issue, I'll respond to it. Or anyone can respond to it, just like that. I'm sure somebody will respond to it. But please do this well before next session. Try to do it today, try to do it tomorrow, but do it as early as possible. Ensure that you're getting temporary opening at zero and you get a reasonable balance sheet. It should be logically consistent. Please do that and we will start with the sales cycle going forward. By the way, this is the way we are going to work over here. I'm not going to tell you that, okay, do this entry, you do it in the entry yourself, then you assist, do this entry, then you do it entry yourself. That will only blindly follow me. You will not learn anything. So I'm purposely putting some question marks, asking you to think over it and make those entries and try it out yourself and check it for yourself. Okay. But I'll be here. Any questions, please feel free to ask in the group and we will look at it. But it's very important that do it. I mean, today's session, unfortunately, not everybody has finished all quizzes. Everybody has not done all the entries. But for next session, I want everybody to have finished quizzes. If you score less marks in first attempt, give a second attempt. Try to score 10 out of 10 in all three quizzes. And please finish all the entries till shown today before you come for the next session. We are done, but if you have any questions, please stay back and I will answer the questions.
Hello, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, can we import a ledger along with their opening balances using some Excel templates or something in ERP?
You can use Excel template to put in these things.
Instead of some companies, they have thousands of ledgers in their balance sheet, and if I want to shift to ERP, in that case, every time I have to record this entry like using general or giving a second effect to temporary account and all. Instead of this, I just want to know that can I import all these thousands of ledgers using some Excel templates directly to ERP?
Yes, yes. There is a way to do it. I'm just not able to find out right now. But yes, you could do that.
Okay.
I will share that URL how to do it. But yes, that is possible. Actually, that is the only way you can do it. Otherwise, it's very difficult to do it manually. Yes, so we are done as far as the session is over. But if you have any questions, please stay back. I will be here for the next 10-15 minutes. Please leave only if you don't have any questions. If you have any questions, doubts, please feel free to stay back and I will answer the questions. I'll stop the recording because the session is done.
GST setup you are going to show in next session?
Yes, GST